We've got 1 million Premier League seasons. So what's happened is, me and my mate Adam, we've got together and we've come up with a mathematical model and we've simulated 1 million seasons in the English Premier League, which is the football league that we have here in England, just to see what happens, basically. Okay, so for those of you who don't know, this is how the Premier League works. It's the top flight of English football, or soccer, as Americans like to call it. And basically, there are 20 teams. Everybody plays each other home and away. And if you win the game, you get 3 points. If you draw, you get 1 point. If you lose, you don't get any points.
That's a big 3 points for Manchester City.
You basically just tot up the points and see who's got the most points. If there's any sort of ties, if some teams have the same number of points, there's no playoffs or anything like that, it goes down to something called goal difference, which is basically you take the number of goals a team has scored and take off the number of goals they've conceded. After that, it goes on goals scored. And after that, they just agree a tie. There's no ranking. And you can actually have literally two teams with identical records in principle. And literally, they won't be ranked. They'll just say, well, equal.
Leading the field is number 11, James Ryan. And he's replaced by number 16, Matt Parker.
Obviously, the goal is to win the championship. But it's also really important to get into the top four, because the teams that get into the top four, they go into something called the Champions League the next season, which is really lucrative, loads of money. The big thing you want to avoid is relegation. So that's finishing in the bottom three. If you finish in the bottom three, you actually drop down to the division below, to the league below, the subsequent season. And that's really bad because obviously it's nowhere near as glamorous, far less income, altogether a whole lower standard of football, and you don't want to be there, basically. So that's the thing to avoid. So football fans everywhere, you know, we like to argue about, you know, how many points do you need to win the league, for example? I mean, that's a big issue this season because, you know, there's two teams that have got really great records, Liverpool and Manchester City, and it looks like you're going to need a lot of points to win the league this season. It's a thing you can ask. Normally, how many points would you need to win the league? How many points do you need to guarantee entry into the Champions League the next season to finish in that top four? And of course, the one that people really worry about is how many points do you actually need to avoid relegation? What people talk about, the magical 40-point mark. So this is why we got interested. We were interested in asking these questions from a mathematical point of view. So of course, we could answer some of these questions theoretically, but in not a very interesting way. So for example, if you get 64 points, you are guaranteed not to be relegated. That's a fact, right? You can show that quite easily. But of course, anybody who gets 64 points, or 63 points actually, is not going to get relegated in any reasonable season. So we wanted to think more about probabilities and what, you know, what's likely to happen. But mathematically, that's pretty much impossible to do, what we call analytically. So you really have to run computer simulations, use this idea of a Monte Carlo simulation. And you use sort of randomness to sort of try to create random seasons. And then over a lot of seasons, the sort of probabilistic scenarios sort of play out. This idea of Monte Carlo simulations, they go back to development of the atomic bomb, actually. So we had a bit of a journey in building our model. We started off with some simpler models and then developed a quite sophisticated one, which is kind of based on the kind of thing that bookmakers use to predict outcomes of games. We use something called a Poisson distribution to sort of get the expected goals we said a given team would have in a given game, and built the model from that. And that used data from last season's Premier League, actually. It's kind of a weird season in as much as Manchester City had an anomalously good season. They got 100 points. We're at the mercy of that, but we had to use something. And we literally played out the games in the simulation. So we did it, as I said, 380 games over a season, a million seasons. It is quite quick. I mean, I'm not going to take the credit for this. I'm sure if I wrote a bit of code that tried to do this, it would take forever. But my friend Adam is much better at that sort of thing than me and was able to write a very efficient code, which did it in about 20 minutes, half an hour or so. And so we were really able to get out some fun statistics out of it. Basically, how many points you need to win the Premier League on average, based on this simulation? Well, it turned out that the mean number of points that finished second place was 85.2. So basically, that's telling us that if you get 86 points, chances are you going to win the league? In reality, you know, the team winning the league was getting 95 points or so in this simulation. Again, that's because City did so well last season and we were using last season's data. To get in the Champions League, for example, on average, you would need 72 points, according to this simulation, which is a reasonable figure. There are some circumstances where you would need a lot more or a lot less, but that was generally the ballpark. Now the crunch to avoid relegation. Well, we can look at the number of points on average scored by the 18th team. So that's the top team that did get relegated. And they got 32.5 points was the mean. So that basically means that 33 points should be enough to avoid relegation based on the sort of the simulations you would get from last season's data. That's quite low. I think that's a bit on the low side. But again, you know, if we'd averaged over more seasons with our data, probably we would have maybe got a higher figure there. So over a million seasons, what sort of things happened? So, for example, what's the most points that somebody won the league with? Needless to say, Manchester City did on 62 occasions score 114 points, which is where they won every single game. So 62 times out of a million seasons, City got all the points that were available. The highest number of points somebody got relegated with. Okay, so that would be a disaster, right? You're going to get relegated on a large number of points. Actually, it wasn't that high in these simulations. The highest number of points somebody got relegated with in our million seasons was 44. And actually, that's kind of close to the sort of Premier League data. West Ham went down on 42. There was a season when teams played a few more games where Crystal Palace went down on 49, which was considered the ultimate disaster.
So in the million seasons, there weren't any cases really where a team got relegated having a really good season?
No, not really. So other things that you notice, the most number of goals scored by a team in a season. Manchester City on one particular season scored 161 goals, which blitzes the actual record, which was set by Aston Villa in 1931, where they scored 128 goals. Again, that was in 42 games. Somebody actually won the league in this as well, only scoring 50 goals. Obviously, Man City did annoyingly well. Out of the 1 million seasons, they won the league nearly 900,000 times. They won it 896,313 times. Actually, the team that won the next most, this is kind of curious. You probably would think, given that we were basing on last season's data, that the second place team from last season, which was Manchester United, would win the next most. That's not what happened. The team that won the next most, which kind of pleases me, was Liverpool. Okay, who finished fourth last season. They won the league in this 45,862 times out of our simulation. So the reason the model favoured Liverpool was because when they won games, they won by a lot. They scored a lot of goals. They won spectacularly when they won last season. So the model kind of likes that.
Over the million seasons in your model, was there a freak season like the famous Leicester season where an underdog came through and won it?
So not really. Okay, so not in the model simulation I'm talking about here. We did do a trial simulation where Leicester, and it was Leicester actually, won the league three times out of a million. In this simulation, this sort of main one, the final one, nobody outside of the top six won the league. Nobody. It's kind of depressing actually.
Did any of the big super teams ever get relegated?
You did, yes, yes. This is quite funny, actually. Chelsea, poor old Chelsea, got relegated five times. They finished second from bottom twice and they finished third from bottom three times. So none of the other big six got relegated. There were a few sort of anomalous things. Southampton did surprisingly well. They finished second once and they got into the Champions League. Get this, they got into the Champions League 22 times out of a million. Okay, which is really, and they're completely anomalous. There's like nobody else sort of that far down the table does anything like that well. Again, it'll be because of the nature of it, how their games played out. They probably scored plenty of goals, that kind of thing. So those are sort of the general overview of the season data. But there's some more fun extremes sitting in there, which we've got to talk about. What's the biggest win that anybody had in our simulation, in our million seasons? Well, needless to say, it was Manchester City, and they beat Bournemouth 20 goals to 1.
Manchester City 20, Bournemouth 1.
So they scored 20 goals, Bournemouth got 1. That's blowing out the water, the kind of thing we've actually seen in real life. The record score in a top flight game is 12-0, done by West Brom over 100 years ago. Also, Nottingham Forest did it over 100 years ago.
But over the course of a million years, it's reasonable that it'll happen one day.
It is, it is. I mean, it's not so crazy that City might occasionally get those kind of score lines over a million seasons. Absolutely not. There were even more other remarkable score lines. Everton seemed to be heavily involved in some crazy score lines. The highest number of goals by a losing team, 10. Chelsea played Everton at Goodison Park. Everton won 11-10, right? Okay, so that's a great... And again, Everton seemed to be involved in a lot of these games. There was a Merseyside derby, which was the highest scoring draw. That was Everton 9, Liverpool 9.
Never in a million years did I think I'd see a game as close as that.
I don't think my heart would be able to cope with a game like that. I went to see Liverpool Everton play and it was a 4-4 draw. But that was bad enough. 9-0, I don't think I could handle.
For Liverpool, leaving the field, number 7, Toki.
The most goals in a game, okay? So the most goals in a game, that was Manchester City beat, again, Everton, 17-5, 22 goals in that game. Actually, the record in English football, in real English football, not in our simulation, was Tranmere Rovers. Tranmere beat Oldham 13-4. So 17-5 is not actually that far away if you think about it. You know, the model's not perfect. One thing it doesn't do very well, for example, is predict nil-nils. The reason for that is because a nil-nil draw is kind of could be kind of a game of attrition. You know, once a team gets sort of set in like that, then that dictates what happens next. And the model doesn't do that because it's really, really about randomness. Okay, so it doesn't really capture nil-nils very well. So that's one of the weaknesses of it. And actually, it's not really clear how you would fix that. That's tricky.
On the screen and below for more about the mathematics of sport.